Good morning, everybody. My name is Samir Arora, and I'm from the marketing team from Multiplexers and Switches product line here at Texas Instruments. This morning, we're going to talk about new product updates and some of the interesting activities or the new product activities happening in the MSS group. Let me quickly get into it. This is going to be the session outline, of course, the introduction to the portfolio. We're going to talk about the precision piece of the portfolio, protection, and the low voltage and the mid voltage portfolio. Also, I'm going to be introducing the industry's smallest leaded package, something around the new technology investment that we are doing here at MSS, and of course, introduction to the TMUX series of multiplexers and the value proposition. And then we'll get into some of the features like low leakage and the enhanced protection, TMUX parts, mid voltage portfolio, and then of course, some advanced notice on the new products and the early samples. Lastly, we're going to cover some of the MSS resources which are available on ti.com that you can use effectively for your design help and the other reference purpose. Okay, quickly let me introduce the multiplexers and signal switches portfolio. We are a 30-year-old group with lots of experience when it comes to MSS products. Portfolio point of view, we have over 1,200 products and roughly 3,000 orderable parts. We have over 20,000 customers across all segments and application areas, and we take a pride that we have a impeccable delivery record. We have 99% devices less than lead time of 12 weeks, rather I would say 8 weeks now. Many packages. At the same time, we continue to invest in some of the new packages. And of course, you can see that we have continued investment to expand the portfolio, which is already pretty large, but we are introducing new products. So this shows the size of the portfolio, and the relative size of the boxes depict the size of the portfolio within each of the categories. Of course, we have lots of general purpose multiplexers and switches. Now, these general purpose multiplexers are cost optimized industry general parts, which are used in multitude applications, and they are essentially the building blocks of many of the applications. We pretty much have the largest portfolio across the industry when it comes to the general purpose, and we continue to invest to introduce more products in this category also. However, after that, we see that we have the precision and the protection, and I would probably spend a few seconds on that. Precision multiplexer will focus on preserving the signal integrity through the MUX. And at the same time, when we talk about the protection multiplexers and switches, they will talk about protecting the upstream and the downstream components, as well as creating protection within the multiplexer itself. You can see some of the key careabouts and the specification. For example, in the precision piece, we focus on low on capacitance, low on resistance, and the charge injection. All of these specifications need to be as small as possible for the better throughput. From the protection side, of course, powered off protection, latch up immunity, and the overvoltage are the key protections which the switches provide to the different circuits. We'll quickly go to the TI packaging and technology. Now, you can see many packages, but basically I really want to focus on the package piece, which is TSOP and the DYY package, and what kind of innovation we are actually doing. As you can see, the relative size of different packages, TSOP is a very standard, industry standard package today. But then what we have is a SOT23 thin package, which is also called a DYY package within TI. What it offers is, it still offers a leaded package, but at the same time, it's 70% smaller in size compared to the standard TSOP package. Another interesting point is that it's a dual footprint option. That means you can actually fit this device within the TSOP package footprint itself, and it still offers you the leaded package with 0.5 mm pitch, but at the same time, it saves you 70% of the space each socket, and so it's a wonderful alternative if you have a space constrained application where you're looking to accommodate many switches, many devices over a single board. So that's going to be a value proposition around this package. The size dimensions are given here, and that's where the entire the value proposition lies here, that we don't really have to go to a QFN package, but the SOT TSOP package itself gives you that advantage. Now, why TMUX? And here are some of the interesting activities. Of course, we have the largest portfolio in the industry, and you have a broad selection of low and mid voltage switches and multiplexers to choose from. The other part is the investment into the new technology, and silicon on insulator is the new technology that we are investing in. And basically the buried oxide proposition here is actually providing us the latch-up immunity and the high voltage performance for all the new devices to come in. So this is where we are actually introducing newer devices from TI in the area of precision and protection where we were not there. And this way we'll be able to offer much more value products to the industry. From the IP perspective, we invested in the lowest and the fastest charge injection and the integrated fault protection area. The graph actually shows the flatness of the charge injection. You can actually see the typical charge injection might be, low or equivalent, but when it comes to the performance across the full range, that is where TI multiplexers give you that advantage that the flatness of the charge injection itself is pretty good across the whole range. And the last piece is support, because that is where the engineers look for additional support from the product point of view. We do have a 24/7 technical support through the E2E portal. This is supported by qualified engineers at TI. Here's a link that you can actually visit for all this support requirements. We also have a database, searchable database, and 3000 TI reference guides for different applications and equipment and the subsystem that you can actually take advantage of. Now, this gives you the multiplexers and switches parts, some of the newer parts with the key features. And these are the key features which we are going to focus on. Some of the important features are powered off protection and support for 1.8 volt logic, because increasingly the power rails are going down and 1.8 volt logic becomes all the more important, in addition to some of the other specification related, precision performance related features like low on state resistance and the low capacitance. These are all the different parts which TI supports, and they've been released, and they are already there on TI.com, and you can actually go there and find more information about these parts. Some of the key features, for example, fail-safe logic. Just to quickly tell you, typically the fail-safe logic will protect downstream components when the logic signal is present in the select pin, when in fact the switch is unpowered, so that logic level present on the select pin might actually, through the ESD diode, power on the VDD and the subsystem B. But in case of our devices, the select pin is kept on high impedance state, which prevents the power from going through VDD and powering off the other components. So basically it creates that protection mechanism. Next is the powered off protection. This is very important when it comes to the protection piece of the portfolio. And this is where, again, this feature will protect the downstream components and the multiplexer when the signal is available at the IO pin. And this shows that if the signal is available on the IO pin, it can actually flow through the ESD diode and power off or power on the processor and the multiplexer itself. However, the same concept works here. The IO pins are kept on high impedance state, and even though the signal is present on IO pin, it doesn't flow through the ESD diode and thereby providing all the necessary protection. Now we'll quickly get into the low voltage multiplexer portfolio piece. And I'm not going to spend much time on this slide, but basically this matrix shows you different parts that we have available across the configuration of, ratio of the channels and the number of the channels. All the parts which start with TMUX are the brand new series, and these are the new generation parts, and that is where, you will find a lot of additional features. Having said that, all the other parts mentioned on these slides are equally good and performing very well in the industry across many applications. Here, let me introduce the TMUX 11 family of multiplexers. These are 1.08 volt up to 5.5 volt. And at the same time, they support the dual supply plus minus 2.5 volt inputs. Low leakage precision amplifier. Why do we say low leakage? Of course, it has an ultra low on leakage of 3 picoamperes, 5 nanoamperes max, and at the same time, low charge injection. You know, they come with the fail-safe logic protection, and the temperature ranges all the way up to 125°C. And we also offer the ultra-small packages here. So it's a overall lots of value proposition here. You can see the, you know, the portfolio family on the right side of the slide. There are all these different parts available with different configuration. And, you know, they are also pin-to-bin compatible replacement options to some of the competition parts out there. Next, this shows, you know, how the device fare against the competition. And here we choose the 8:1 single channel configuration. As you can see that, you know, all these green show you the kind of advantages this device offer against the competition. So not only it's a pin-to-pin compatible option, it's also is a better performance option. And TMUX 1108 fares much better as compared to the competition, all respects of performance, package, and the specifications. This TI advantage holds across all the configurations, all the other parts. Here, I'm just showing a standard you know, kind of a use case where we need to monitor multiple sensor by one ADC, and we need a very strong throughput. The signal needs to be, you know, strongly communicated or passed on to the ADC without any loss of signal. And that is where TMUX 11 is a wonderful part, which supports with the low leakage current and the low charge injection. It creates the flatness of the signal throughout the range. Of course, there are lots of other parts that can be used in the similar application, depending upon voltage, which are listed down in the table below. There's another part, which is a TMUX 1308, 1309, which is 8:1 and 1:1 channel configuration. Now, this is one of the industry standard parts, and this is a pin-to-pin upgrade compatible option to all the parts like HC4851 and 4051. Also with 4852 and 4052. This is a 1.8 volt control logic, rail-to-rail operation. It comes equipped with the fail-safe logic operation, and this part is also available in the automotive configuration too. Another part is that we do have this small SOT23 thin package available that I spoke about earlier on during the packaging slide. That means we have a small package option available, which is a leaded 0.5 mm pitch, and giving all the space saving advantages to the design. Some of the application where this device is being used consistently in the large numbers. This is the competition landscape, and basically it shows how TMUX 1308 is a better option for many of the applications. You can see that it has a low on resistance at 25°C, and of course, compatible on resistance at 125°C. It has lots of other features that the current industry parts do not offer, but at the same time, you know, we do have the advantage of the new technology, smaller package, and the better performance. So this, all in all, this is a much better performance and, you know, for large industrial applications out there. The third part is the TMUX 15 series. Now, this is the protection piece of the multiplexers, because this device comes with the powered off protection and the fail-safe logic, the two features that we spoke of earlier on. And of course, it has a low on resistance and the low on capacitance combined with the you know, small package options too. So this device is again a low voltage option, 1.5 to 5.5 volt. Comes in two different configuration, 1511, which is a 1:1 configuration, 1574, which is a 1:2 configuration. And it also lists down some of the applications which, you know, this device is very useful in. Here is a small comparison against some of the competition out there. You can see this provides a lot of advantage. And not only TMUX 15xx is a simple pin-to-pin, but it's also is superior product and it's a better option, compared to the competition. And because of all the reasons listed on the right side of the slide, you can see it eliminates the need for a level translator because it is 1.8 volt compatible. A lot of older devices are not. Enable a faster sampling system because of the low capacitance. Protects the I/O signal path from system power rail, and at the same time, it is offered in the smallest 4-channel QFN package in the industry also. So all in all, lots of advantages from the performance perspective, also from the space saving aspect. With this, now we get to the mid-voltage piece of the portfolio. And here, again, a similar kind of a matrix to show you what are the different parts available in different configurations and the number of channels. These are all the parts which are available in production out there, and you can actually latch on to ti.com or get in touch with the local field sales representative to get more information on these parts. One of the mid-voltage families is TMUX61XX family, and if you look at the table on the right side, it actually introduces TMUX61 series as well as MUX36 series. Both these series are available in different channel configurations. You can see the only difference between the two is on the VDD, the voltage supply. The MUX36 supports plus minus 5 volt to 18 volts. 61 supports plus minus 5 volt to 16.5 volt. But if it's a single volt voltage, that's where there is a difference between the two families. But at the same time, they are viable options to some of the competitions out there. They come with a low leakage current, low charge injection, and it's a very cost-optimized solution out there, from the application point of view. Some of the areas, factory automation, test and measurement, and data center interconnectivity kind of application where these devices are very useful. Here is one of the application, coming again from the low leakage current. That's where these devices provide, this kind of an advantage. You can see that TMUX11XX as well as TMUX61 series can actually be used for these kind of an application. And basically, it's the use case is, need to select a different gain or attenuation ratio according to the input signal profile. And that's where, these different parts which are listed on this table provide the, optimized use case for an application. The next is the MUX50X family. Now, this is again a 36 volt low capacitance and a low leakage current. You can actually see that it's an ultra low input leakage, which is as small as 1 picoamps, and of course, a low charge injection and the flattest charge injection across the whole range. White supplies and some of the other parts available, which give you the viable option against some of the competition out there. The last piece is going to be the resource, where you can get some additional information about the TI multiplexers and signal switches products. Here you can see that when it comes to the web presence on ti.com, you actually have all this database and excellent reference designs available to solve your system level challenges. At the same time, I already spoke about the E2E portal and the support from the qualified engineers of TI. If you have any questions, you can actually latch onto the portal, put your inquiry, and within 24 hours, you will have the response coming up. And there are lots of online in-person trainings also. Another part is now you can order from TI store. If you go to ti.com and go to the TI store, you have an option to choose and pick your devices across all the portfolios, not just MSS, and you can actually place your orders and get your delivery at your doorstep.